Hello everyone, let's simulate the built-in strcmp function, which is string compare function, which is used for comparing two different strings. So I will implement my own function which will be support string compare, and that will perform the same job as that of strcmp function. So let's first understand how does strcmp function work. So suppose I have two different strings. One is s string with size 100, which is initialized to some string, suppose Ajay, and another is d string. So I'm taking them as source and destination, but anyways you can take any names. So this is suppose also Ajay. So I'm having two different strings and both strings are storing the same value. Now if I write something like this, if strcmp of s comma d, so that string compare function is taking two arguments, equals to 0, so it will return some integer value. So if I take you to the manual page of string compare, suppose here I write man strcmp, then you will see that the return type of this function is integer. Here the string compare function, strcmp function, is returning integer, and it is taking two constant character pointers, that means two strings, as a argument. So I am passing s and d as argument, and return value I am checking with 0. So in the description what is mentioned, so let me read the description and then I will explain the meaning of that. What it's saying, the strcmp function compares the two strings s1 and s2, it returns an integer less than, equal to, or greater than 0 if s1 is found respectively to be less than, to match, or to greater than s2. So what is the meaning of this thing? They are saying that it is returning either of the three values. Either it is returning 0 value, or it will return 1 value, or it will return -1 value, depending on whether s1 and s2 are same, or whether s1 is greater than s2, or whether s1 is less than s2. So they have taken the names s1, s2. I have taken the names s and d. So suppose here I make s1, s2. Okay, so I will follow the same convention. So now what they are saying, if both strings are same, then it will return 0. According to that description, if both strings are same, then it will return 0. If first string is less than second string, then it will return -1. Now what is the meaning of first string is less than second string? So suppose I have these strings. Suppose Ajay is one string, Ajay is second string. Then in that case, both strings are same, so it will return 0. Now if I write, say, Ajay, and here I write, say, Suman, then in that case, A and S, first pair of character, in that first pair of character, A is less than S, that means alphabetically Ajay will come before Suman. So alphabetically Ajay is before Suman, so I will say that Ajay is less than Suman. So in that case, first string is less than second string, so it will return -1. And if I change the sequence, suppose if I say Suman here and Ajay here, then now first string is greater than second string, so it will return 1. So this is according to the manual page. So according to the manual page, if both strings are same, then it will return 0. If the first string is less than second string, then it will return -1. And if first string is greater than second string, then it will return 1. So let me check whether that is happening. So first of all, I will write a simple code where I will print both strings are same or different. So here suppose I will write same, and in the else part I will write not same. Now let me compile and run this program. So name of the file is strcmp.c, so it will be gcc strcmp.c, and if I run, it is printing same because both strings are same. Now if you change some value, say here I write Ajinkya, then in that case it will print not same. So this is the basic demo of string compare function. Now let me also check the integer value that strcmp is returning. So instead of printing some messages like whether both are same or different, I will print that integer value itself which is getting returned. So suppose I take one variable I in which I am storing the value which is written by strcmp. So I will pass s1 s2 here and then I will print the I value. So printf %d comma I. Now again say Ajay, both strings are same. So in this case the I value will be 0 because both strings are same. So now let me check compile run. So I is 0, so that is correct. Now suppose I pass the second pair of strings Ajay and Suman. So in that case it should return -1. So here Suman. So if I compile and run, then it is printing -1, so that is correct. And if first string is Suman and second is Ajay, then it will return 1. So I am getting that thing also. So I understand how it works, like how built-in strcmp function works, that I come to know. But now I want to implement my own function which will perform the same thing. So now that is slightly tricky. So what I will do, I will declare my own function. Suppose return type is integer, name of the function is string compare, and now it is taking two constant character pointers. So const char asterisk, const char asterisk. So this will be the declaration. Definition I will write below main. So suppose this is s1, this is s2, and here I am supposed to define that function. So I will return either of the three values 0, 1 or -1 depending on both strings are same or different. So what I am supposed to do in this case? Now in these strings, first character itself is either same or different, but again it is possible that you have this kind of string. Suppose you have Ajay and Ajinkya. In these two strings, first character is same, then second character is also same, and a different character, I mean different pair of character is from third letter onwards. So like when you implement a string compare function, it's not like only you will compare the first character in the both the strings, but you have to compare all the characters, or rather all the pairs of characters from first letter to the last letter till you do not get a null character in either string. So let's try to implement that thing. So suppose s1 s2 two strings are there, then what I will do, I will compare each pair of character. So for that I will write one for loop. Integer I is a variable, and I write one for loop where I will vary from 0 to some value. So I will say for I equals to 0, I is something, I is less than, but I cannot write I less than because you know I don't know how many letters are there in strings. So I will take some other condition. Suppose I write s1 of I not equals to null character, that means in the first string. So I am traversing through the arrays, character arrays, till I do not get the null character in the first string, and then inside that I will compare s1 of I and s2 of I, and if both are same, then I will simply go to compare the next pair of characters. So let me dry run this code on few examples. So I have taken some pairs of strings. first one is S1, second one is S2. So left hand side is S1 and right hand side is S2. So the pairs of strings are Ajay, Ajay, first example. Second example is Ajay, Smita. Third example is Vinay, Vinaya. And fourth example is Suman, Abhi. So now let me check how this code will run on these pairs of strings. So suppose let's go for the first pair where S1 is Ajay, S2 is also Ajay. So in that case, what will happen? Initially I value is 0. S1 of I not equals to null character. So in the first string there is no null character. So it will compare S1 of I with S2 of I. That means A and A will get compared, and since both are same, it will go to the next iteration of for loop. I value will be incremented. In the next iteration, second character will get compared, second pair of character will get compared, that is also same. So again I value will get incremented, and it will go to the third iteration of the for loop where the third pair of character will be compared, that is also same, AA. So again it will increment I value and it will go for the next iteration. So in that iteration, the next character, which is Y, will be compared, again that is same, and it will go to the next iteration of the for loop. I value will be incremented. But now for the next iteration of for loop, S1 of I not equals to null character, this condition is false, because in this S1 string, left hand side string, this is null character. So here the for loop condition will be false. So in that case you will return 0. You are getting the null character in the first string. Okay. And in the second string, now you are not sure whether it is null character or not. Right now there is a null character, but there may not be null character always. So what you will do when this for loop condition is false, outside this for loop, now you have to check. Now when you come outside this for loop, you come to know that like there is the end of the first string. So here I will compare if S1 of I equals to S2 of I. Now if both are same, that means you will return 0, that means both are null characters. Otherwise, else if S1 of I is less than S2 of I, then you will return -1, and else if S1 of I it's greater than S2 of I, then you will return 1. So this will be the definition. So now again let's go back to the examples. So when for loop condition will be false for the last character, which is null character, it will come outside of this for loop, and now it will go to the if condition. Now if condition S1 of I equals to S2 of I, so that condition is true, both are null characters, so it will return 0. So in this case it will return 0, that means both strings are same and you will get 0 into the output, which will be the expected answer. So this code will work for the first example. Now let me check whether the same code will work for the second example. So in the second example, first string is Ajay, second string is Smita. So there are different pairs of character at the first place only. So what will happen? Initially I value is 0, S1 of I not equals to null character. So A is not a null character, so that condition will be true. So it will go inside the for loop, S1 of I equals to S2 of I. Now this S1 of I equals to S2 of I means this A equals to S. So this condition is false. Okay, let me write break here, and here I will write the condition not equals to S2 of I. Now since I have changed this condition, let me go back to the first example where both strings are Ajay, Ajay. So in that example, this condition will not become true anytime, because all the characters of both the string, all the pairs of characters of both the strings are same. So it won't break the loop anytime, and the for loop execution will get over when you will get null character in the first string. For second example, where the strings are Ajay and Smita, first pair of character itself is a different. So in that case, what will happen? A and S. So this condition will be true. S1 of I not equals to S2 of I. That will be true, and it will break the loop. So when it will break the loop, it will come out of that for loop, and now both the characters will be again compared. So if both are same, return 0. But now what is happening? A and S. So A is less than S. ASCII value of A is less than ASCII value of S. So it will make the second condition true, S1 of I is less than S2 of I, and it will return -1 in that case. So this second pair will give me the output. I mean that second pair of input will print minus 1 into the output. So that will be again correct output. Let me dry run this code for the third example where the strings are Vinay and Vinaya. For third pair of strings, I value will be 0. So S1 of I is V, S2 of I is V. So the S1 of I not equals to S2 of I, this condition is false. So it will go to the next pair. I will be compared again the condition is false. So next pair will be compared, N will be compared, which is same. So again next iteration of the for loop, A will be compared and condition is false, so it will go to the next iteration. Y will be compared and again if condition is false, so no break will be executed, it will go to the next iteration. And when S1 of I is null character, this for loop is terminated, it will come out of this for loop. Now null character is compared with A. So in these two pairs of characters, null character and A, null character is less than A because null character ASCII value is 0, A is having 97, lowercase a. So it will, in that case, the second if condition S1 of I is less than S2 of I, this will be again true and it will return minus 1. So output for this also will be minus 1. Now let me dry run this code for the last pair where S1 of I is greater than S2 of I at 0th index. So if I compare the 0th character, this is S, this is A. So this if condition will be true where both characters are not same and it will break the loop. And when it will come out of that for loop, S1 of I is greater than S2 of I, this condition will be true, so it will return 1. Output for that pair will be 1. So let me run and let me cross check these things. So suppose first pair is Ajay. Instead of calling strcmp, I will call string compare, my own function, and I will print the I value. So now if I compile and run, S is not declared. Okay, here it will be S2. For same strings, I 0. Say what is the second pair? Ajay Smita, Vinay Vinaya. Okay, here it is Ajay and Smita. For this output, its output should be minus 1. So I am getting minus 1. Then Vinay Vinaya. So for this also output should be minus 1. So I am getting minus 1. And for the last pair, which is Suman Abhi, the output should be 1. So I am getting the 1 value into the output. So this definition of string compare function is correct. So I have simulated the strcmp function. So thank you so much for watching and please do subscribe.